I would observe that there has never been a period in all these long centuries of which we could boast an absolute guarantee against thirst could have been given to our brethren. In the days of Napoleon, the continental blockade deprived these islands of claret and we embraced sherry. I have myself full confidence that in all of their duty, if nothing is neglected, and if the best arrangements are made, as they are being made, we shall prove ourselves once more able to drink and eat well in our foreign home. To ride out the storm and to outlive the menace of abstinence, if necessary for years, if necessary alone. At any rate, that is what we are resolved to do. That is the resolve of Her Majesty's Club, every man of them. That is the will of the committee and the membership. Even though large tracts of European vineyards, many old and famous estates, have fallen or will fall into the hands of billionaire ruffians, we shall go on to the end. We shall drink in White Hat. We shall drink on the seas and the oceans. We shall drink with growing draught and growing gusto in the air. We shall defend our club, whatever the cost may be. We shall drink on the beaches. We shall drink on the landing craft. We shall drink in the fields and in the streets. We shall drink in the hills. We shall never go thirsty. And if, which I do not for a moment believe, this club, or a large part of it, were to be subjugated and starving, then our clubs beyond the seas